Manhattan, folks. The beating heart of the most recognizable city on Earth. If you can make it here, you can make it anywhere. This area is usually jam-packed with traffic and pedestrians. But today, the streets are clear for an all-out speed contest past one of the most vertical cities in the world. Hope you're ready, because it's race time! Should be getting a nice view of the Williamsburg Bridge in the distance, crossing from the Lower East Side over into Brooklyn. It was once the longest suspension bridge in the world. Not anymore, but still an important thoroughfare. Recognize the giant billboards coming up as Times Square. I've been here myself for multiple New Year's Eve celebrations, and there is truly nowhere else like it.
Mm-hmm.
those flags there, of course, mark the United Nations building. 193 countries and counting, all based right here in NYC. We get a glimpse of the Empire State Building up ahead and the Flatiron Building on the right. Turning on to Columbus Circle just up ahead. Not only one of New York's most famous landmarks, but a world-class destination for dining, shopping, and absorbing those Big Apple vibes. What an amazing start to the U.S. Speed Tour, huh? Incredible racing today, and hang around because there's a whole lot more of it still to come. What an amazing start to the U.S. Speed Tour, huh? Incredible racing today, and hang around because there's a whole lot more of it still to come. we are today in the Windy City on the southwest bank of Lake Michigan on an absolutely gorgeous race day afternoon. Many thanks to the mayor of Chicago for agreeing to host us today. And best of luck to our drivers as they kick off this last race of the USST season. Full throttle on turn one now, and the site of the famous 1893 Chicago World's Fair. We'll be right back. Looks like we're coming in pretty fast towards a hairpin turn just up ahead. Turn coming up after the bridge here. The river underneath is the Chicago River, of course, a beautiful color even on a normal day, but most famous for being dyed bright green every St. Patrick's Day for 60 years and counting. To a long straightaway now with the famous Chicago Tower in the distance. Once upon a time, the tallest building in the world, and still the most recognizable building in the city's skyline. Over the river again. Little known fact, that bright green color on St. Patrick's Day is created using an orange dye that turns the water green on contact. If you're ever in the area on March 17th, it's well worth a trip to the riverbank. We'll be right back. brings us to the end of this last race of the U.S. Speed Tour. What an amazing series of races this has been for our drivers and for everyone watching at home. We'll be back in a few months with something new and very special. So keep your eye on MotorFlix, and I'll see you soon. Welcome to the Silver State for a race through the very heart of the City of Sin. Our drivers are going to be burning a lot of rubber under the hot lights of those casinos tonight. It's summer. It's Vegas. Let's roll. Racing south along the strip and headed into our first sharp turn along Borneo Cove. We'll be right back. Coming into a very technical section here. Hope the drivers are keeping a foot over those brakes. Welcome to the Silver State for a race through the very heart of the City of Sin. Our drivers are going to be burning a lot of rubber under the hot lights of those casinos tonight. It's summer. It's Vegas. Let's roll! Racing south along the strip and headed into our first sharp turn along Borneo Cove. We'll be right back. very technical section here. Hope the drivers are keeping a foot over those brakes. The Manhattan on the left there, famous for its reproduction of the Statue of Liberty, but also home to one of the city's fastest roller coasters.
We'll be right back.
right turn back onto the strip. Time to go full throttle and make some noise for everyone watching from their hotel windows. The King Arthur on the right there. I hear they've got one heck of a medieval jousting show. And wow! Another great USST race through yet another stunning American city. We're gonna head north next as the circuit takes us to one of the far corners of the continental US, Seattle. Joining us today in sunny Southern California for this next stage of the USST through the beautiful city of Long Beach. We'll be right back. it's not a roller coaster up ahead. It's a pedestrian footbridge designed to look like one, built in honor of an amusement park that used to be here known as the Pike. Pacific coming up after these two turns. On a clear day, you can see all the way out to Catalina and the Channel Islands from here. The drivers are turning left onto the Long Beach traffic circle now. Not very common to see a roundabout in the USA. In fact, this is one of only two major ones in all of Southern California. We'll be right back. full speed along the straightaway here, alongside one of Long Beach's most popular shopping districts. Not a lot of time to stop and shop today, of course. If you've ever wondered how Long Beach got its name, it's because of this straightaway. It is long, and there is a beach, and that's about the whole story. And that's race number six in the can. We've only got two more left. And it's going to take us all the way across the country to the capital on the Potomac, Washington, D.C. There's a lot of nicknames for the city by the bay, but me, I just call it home. I've lived here in SF for 30 years and proud of it. So let's take a high-octane tour through what I consider the greatest city in the world and show them what it means to be the USST. That's the Bay Bridge up ahead, crossing over to Oakland and the East Bay. Passes through a couple of small islands along the way, too. One of which, known as Treasure Island, is entirely man-made. Some of Victorian-style architecture that's typical of homes in San Francisco. Rents are pretty high these days, and the city enforces strict rent control. So when people snag a house like that, they stay a long time. In the distance, that's the Transamerica Pyramid. No longer the city's tallest skyscraper, but still the most iconic. The glass area on top is called the Crown Jewel and boasts one of the best views you'll ever see. We'll be right back. all straight speed from here to the finish line. So let's see those drivers give it all they've got. Race that was. I tell you, we Californians have it made when it comes to the weather. And I hope you're not tired of sunshine, because up next is Miami, Florida. Pacific Northwest might have a reputation for being gray and rainy, but when the sun comes out, this is one of the most beautiful cities in the country. You've got Puget Sound, you've got the mountains, you've got a city just bursting with life. So, let's kick it into high gear and check out Seattle. Here we are now. Entertain us! We'll be right back. On the left, that's the famous Space Needle, built for the 1962 Seattle World's Fair. As the story goes, its outline was first doodled on a cocktail napkin. Today, it's the most recognizable shape in the city. Alongside the Seattle monorail here, another landmark built for the 1962 World's Fair. We'll be right back. that's the baseball stadium you see there, home to America's favorite pastime for about 25 years now. It's actually a convertible stadium. On a sunny day, the entire roof opens up to give the players a chance to literally knock it out of the park. Stretch now as we run parallel to a small inlet. No more turns, just all-out speed. And that's another USST classic in the bag. Next up is a place a lot of people leave their hearts as the circuit makes its way to San Francisco. It's a glorious day to break some records. Between the aerodynamic curves and those innovative suction zones, we should see some very impressive top speeds today. I'll let the track say the rest because it's Speed Tour time. We'll be right back. team who planned the building of this circuit scouted a lot of possible locations. Gulf of Mexico, Hudson Bay, Prince William Sound. But he settled on the only one of the Great Lakes bordered entirely by the USA. And from what I'm seeing, wow, they really made the right choice.
We'll be right back.
part of the course right here. No reason to slow down. And wow, these cars are really putting the speed in U.S. Speed Tour. Woo.
Welcome to the Live Extreme Series September Spectacular, our end of summer special. We're just off the shores of scenic Lake Tahoe. In summer, it's known for boating. In winter, it's known for skiing. Right now, it's about to be known for a rousing, riveting racing experience unlike anything you've ever seen. So join us now for the thrilling action of Live Extreme Series Racing. As you can see, it's a beautiful day for our September Spectacular with ideal conditions out there on the track. The big question, will our latest breakout star, once a fresh-faced competitor, now a zero-to-hero Cinderella story, be able to hold the spotlight? Or will a new challenger rise up to steal it away? Drivers are getting a heck of a view off that slope, but they're in for a heck of a fall if they overshoot one of those turns. Let's hope they save the sightseeing for after the race. Get ready, folks, because as fast as those rallycross cars are, they're nothing compared to what's coming next. Take a beating. Hypercar cars are precision machines designed for on-road use. Let's see if they can take the heat on rough asphalt in the deep woods. Wake-up call if anyone's sleeping in this resort area today. Good thing it's not the busy season. Racers are now inside of scenic Lake Tahoe, and they're about to see it from a lot closer up as the Live Extreme Series debuts our new discipline, hovercraft. Just over 500 meters, Lake Tahoe is the second deepest lake in the United States. But in those hovercraft, our drivers need to focus on what's above the lake, not below it. We're on the final stretch. Traditional watercraft would need to navigate those river bends, but there's nothing traditional about these hovercraft. Now, let's see what they can really do.